Hey everybody, so it is a absolutely beautiful day and I'm headed out to the chickens to give them some strawberries that aren't edible anymore. And I'm gonna take a look at the kale, uncover that. Gotta pull some of that today for one of my customers and some salad greens as well. So I'm gonna enjoy this morning before I head off to the gym later. You can hear the geese now. Oh, and update. So we have Lily, I believe. I can't tell the two geese apart, but we have one of the geese who are actually have gone broody and are laying on eggs. So we're gonna have baby geese. Birds are chirping. It's relaxing. Can't tell you how happy it makes me. Looking to the garden. Good morning, Miss Blue. So I had Kevin go ahead and till this up yesterday while I was at work. Went ahead and did it even though it was probably too wet to, just because it hasn't stopped raining and we're expecting more rain. Yesterday was a pretty day. We've had a few pretty days and I didn't want to lose the chance to get something worked up in the ground and get rid of some of the weeds that had grown in it. We also have to actually add topsoil to this part because this is the low-lying part here. So we're going to add some topsoil to it as well as some manure to it. And then hopefully that'll raise it up some. And then I'll be able to go ahead and plant some more greens in it. I'd really hope to be able to show you planting with my seeder and how that works, especially with such little seeds. It really helps save the back. But we won't be able to do that today, but hopefully in the near future. You can see the clumps. You see, it's not too bad. It's not as bad as I expected, honestly, but it's still not really the best. So we'll give it a little more time, work in it a little bit, get the little weeds out, and then we'll try to plant it. And I'll show y'all how my seeder works. That in itself is a workout. Whew. It will definitely make your back hurt. Okay, sorry about the sun. I'm gonna show you exactly why it's important to mulch. Okay, now I'm ready. Okay, so I wanna show you the difference in mulching and not mulching and how important it is. One, during the summer, it definitely helps with retaining moisture, which you've seen in some of my previous videos. It also helps keep the weeds out. But just to show you the difference in how well it keeps the weeds out, you can see here, there are some weeds in here, but there's not a lot of weeds here. And so I did mulch all of the kale with straw that I bought from a local farmer. He's someone I used to go to school with, him and his wife. That's from the Turner Family Farm in Dinwiddie County. And then walk over here, and none of these salad greens were actually mulched. And so I really wish now I had, but you can see the drastic difference. I mean, there's just weeds everywhere, and technically it's choking out the plants probably. Some of the smaller ones that could be doing a lot better. So you see here, and then you have some bigger here. So definitely mulch. Doesn't matter what you do, whether you use plastic, whether you use straw, use old hay, maybe even use leaves. I've used pine tags. I know my peppers love pine tags. Let's go over here where the butter crunch lettuce is, and see there is nothing but weeds everywhere. So drastic difference between the kale and the lettuce. Lesson learned, it's worth it. Now, my kale just in the last 2 days has literally gone leggy. It's starting to flower, if you see here. So it won't be long and we'll have to actually pull this up. Whatever is left, I will actually harvest and give to the animals. So the goats, the chickens, the ducks, the rabbits love it, all of it. So once it gets to the point where I can no longer harvest it because of the taste, because I don't want it to get super bitter, then we'll actually still use it for the animals. So, and they love the greens. So let's talk a little bit about why I love kale so much. Kale is a leafy green in the brassica family. It is in the family with cabbages and Brussels sprouts and broccoli, for those of you who are not familiar with gardening. My favorite thing about kale is not just the taste and the ease of growing it, but also the fact that kale is a nutritional powerhouse. It has insane amounts of thiamine, riboflavin, vitamin B6, vitamin C, vitamin A, two of the things that are most important to me, fiber and iron. I'm extremely anemic on a regular basis without medication and proper diet. And so kale really helps to make my iron levels more sustainable. Butternut squash is another thing that has a lot of iron in it. But we're talking about kale today. So there are so many things that you can do with kale. For a lot of people, putting kale in a salad, just a kale with some other ingredients, is great. If kale is not quite your thing as far as just kale, you can always just add it to your leafy greens. You don't have quite as much kale. You can put it in the omelet. We talked about that many times before. You can actually powder it and put it in your smoothies, or you can just cut it and put it in your smoothies. So for anybody who is searching for a healthy way to consume kale and not just in the leafy form of a salad, do some research. It's amazing what you can find on Pinterest these days. Pinterest is my friend. I do tons of research on Pinterest. It inspires me so much to try to learn new things and try new things. But kale is absolutely amazing. It's really easy to grow, guys. So you typically are going to grow it between September and early spring. It is known to bolt if you go too far into the summer, unless you have an area like I have where there is extreme shade. So there's enough sun in the morning to help it grow, but there's actual shade. And so the area that you saw earlier in the video that I had Kevin till up, that is actually where I will have
lettuces and kales, more cooler crops growing throughout the summer because it doesn't get that direct sun. It has a cooler air flow through there. And I have been successful in having these type of things grow all summer long, but not placing them directly in the most sunny spots of my garden. And frankly, I like having kale all year long. I get kind of depressed when I don't have kale all year long. The other vegetable or leafy green that I really love to have all year long is arugula. It has a bite and a kick to it, so it's not necessarily something that you're going to eat by itself. But again, in the omelet, it is even better than the kale because it gives it just that little bit of bite that you normally would get from pepper. And so you don't have to put as much pepper, and it's natural growing. I absolutely love it. My customers, however, they like kale better. So, hence why I have 8 rows of kale is because it is an amazing vegetable. It is a nutrition powerhouse. Again, I can't express that enough, and customers like it. So, let's head over to the rabbits. We have a mother rabbit who's getting ready to have babies in the next couple of days. So really, really excited about that. And I'm gonna show you that now. So give me a minute. So there's Mama down there now. And just so you can see, she started 2 days ago pulling her fur. So this is a sign that you know that she is getting close to birth. So pretty excited about that, hopefully within the next day or so, maybe tonight even. But we'll be happily awaiting new babies. All right, Mama, heading down there. And then I'll show you the other babies that we had grown previously. They are getting ready to be to the age of slaughter. Actually, they're probably past due because they were born in December and it is now March. So here they are. We do actually sell rabbits to anybody interested, but what we don't sell, we will keep some of the females possibly and slaughter the males. We don't need any more males at this time. They're getting pretty big. Again, they were born in December. Got some pretty brown ones, kind of a mix. The last ones that were brown were more harlequin, like the mom you just saw. Hi guys. Alright guys, so that is it for me for the vlog today. I am going to be heading off to the gym. I hope that you have enjoyed learning a little bit about kale. I hope that I've inspired you to actually grow kale if you weren't planning on growing kale. If you are not sure whether or not it is worth your time, carve out a small piece of the garden and plant a small amount so that you can try it that way. It is a cut and come again product, so I am able or have been able to get probably close to 4 cuttings from my kale in many cases. As you do cut it though, it does a lot of times become a little bit tougher, but it's still usable depending on what you're using it for. And if you don't have a garden or you don't have a piece of property that you can grow kale in, you can always grow kale in pots. It's amazing. You can cut it and come again from your patio. So try it out. If you would like some recipes that I use for incorporating kale into my diet, then feel free to reach out to me. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you'd like to see more videos and get notified, then definitely subscribe. Sorry about the noise. There's a train going by. But have a great day, y'all.
This one's white. Where do you want to sit? What did you pick?
My hands.
Blue flower. You have purple flowers.
Mm-hmm.
And blue flowers.